Welcome to the training videos regarding eSignatures and eSealing for project records and records set plans. This series of videos and this introduction will cover the training required in order to understand how CDOT is using electronic signatures for sealing general documents that are basic or less complex and more complex documents. The topics you'll be exposed to include the following: the requirements for eSignatures and sealing, an introduction to Adobe Sign, an overview of the workflow itself, and getting started with Adobe Sign Project Share. The videos are available for Adobe Sign and ProjectWise and Project Share. The requirements for eSealing using signatures and professional engineers or architects or surveyor seals are really driven by several things, one of which is the EDC or Everyday Counts initiative that's been sponsored by the FHWA, which is an effort to increase the efficiency of DOTs in the delivery of projects through the application of technology. The other two things that drive it are procedural directives signed by CDOT's executive director, which involve two things, the first of which is the engineer's stamp and what governs when it's used, how it's used, under what conditions, and on what media. That's referred to as PD 508.1, the Professional Engineer's Seal. The other procedural directive is known as 21.1 and really involves the retention of project records for design, construction, and engineering, and any records generated by specialty groups like right-of-way, survey, and utilities. Within 21.1, Adobe Sign's been selected as a software used for electronic signatures on project records, which are defined in 21.1 essentially as any records that have to do with the creation, design, or execution of the project. So that would take you from design through construction. It also covers, among many other things, the legal retention requirement for records, which is split between 3.5 years and less, or 3.5 years or more. If a document is required to be retained 3.5 years or less, it can be retained in paper format or electronically. If it's 3.5 years or more, it must be smart scanned, which is defined a little later. But smart scanning is a word coined by CDOT to actually discuss how a record is compressed, page aligned, made readable through optical character recognition, and placed in an ISO compliant format, which guarantees the file will be readable for many decades in the future, regardless of the software or hardware used to create the file. All active future project records shall be retained in ProjectWise. Those three bullets are the backbone of 21.1. An introduction to Adobe Sign. What is it? Well, it's a cloud-based e-signature program for e-sealing documents. It also digitally routes and tracks the documents for signing. It's all done automatically. And it allows users to send, sign, seal, track, and manage signatures in the sealing process using basically any mobile device. So you could use your cell phone, a browser, a tablet, or the computer in your office. You're not limited to responding to signature requests at the office. You can be anywhere using any mobile device as long as you have internet access. CDOT uses Adobe Sign because it's the only signature and e-sealing software that routes and tracks large files up to 50 megabytes. And that's necessary for plan sets, for instance, which routinely are over 50 megabytes. We look at the overview of the workflow for Adobe Sign. Essentially, what you do is create and save your source documents in any format. You can use an Excel file, a PDF. It really doesn't matter. It can be a DGN file. And in the process, the workflow in Adobe Sign will create a PDF out of that document as it routes it. It prepares the documents for signatures or e-sealing. It allows the documents to be sent for signing or sealing automatically. And it has the ability to track the documents. Every transaction from the opening of a file, closing, signing it, forwarding it, every action that's taken by any computer in the automated workflow is tracked. The documents can automatically be archived in ProjectWise via the Adobe Sign ProjectWise integration, which allows ProjectWise to talk to Adobe Sign and vice versa. So a record can start out in ProjectWise, be passed off to Adobe Sign, be sent for signature, all signatures executed, and when it's done, it's placed back in ProjectWise automatically. So to get started, there isn't any software to install if you're only going to sign documents. If you're not sending documents for a signature, but you are a recipient, which is what Adobe Sign calls someone who signs, you call it a recipient, there isn't any software to install. All you need is access to the internet and a smart device. It can be your cell phone, a tablet, or your computer, and you'll get it in the form of an email. You only need a license or a subscription for Adobe Sign if you are actually going to prepare a document for signature and routing. So that's why it says signing documents only. If that's all you're doing is signing it, you don't need to have a license or a subscription to Adobe Sign. CDOT employees will go to the help desk online or place a phone call or an email to OIT and ask for access to Adobe Sign. For third parties, external CDOT, Adobe Sign is available online at adobe.com. Project Share. What is that? Project Share is available in several formats, and it allows you to connect to ProjectWise, whether you're internal or external, from the cloud in a very easy-to-use format, which does not require use of CDOT's VPN. So as long as you have credentials to ProjectWise, getting access to ProjectWise can be done, as I said, without a VPN using Project Share. And you can see with the video on screen there, the image, that the resources where the arrow points is where you start. There's a number of videos available about the topics we've been discussing, which are taken some in order as prerequisites before you can proceed. These are some of the videos that are available for the use of Adobe Sign. It really depends on what your document, what type of document you have. In other words, is it a simple, less complex document that requires only a signature or two or three? Maybe it's a single or dual page document. That's what we're referring to as a less complex project record involving a construction project. The more complex project records would really primarily involve, almost exclusively, record sets, because they're the documents which are large. And that's the documents a professional engineer, land surveyor, landscape architect, or someone else who had a professional seal that needed to sign and use. So these videos basically describe what you have to do in some cases to make the file small enough in order for Adobe Sign to be able to handle it. And once you've broken it into pieces, how to reassemble those pieces into a single PDF after it's been executed in Adobe Sign and still maintaining all of the validity of the signatures. The second one involves a task of taking an image, which is a license seal, and the signature image, two different images, and placing them together as a single image for use on record sets. Those have to be completed prior to taking the last video there on using Adobe Sign, because you have to have the first two complete. In other words, a file less than 50 megabytes, less than 999 pages, and a combination image of your seal and signature before you can finish that video. Remaining videos involve the topic of Project Share, which again is the cloud-based program which allows access to ProjectWise itself without use of the VPN from the cloud. This link here gives you the basic topics, covers those topics in ProjectWise Share. Even without these videos, it's such an easy to use interface, you might even be able to get by without the instructions at all. But it's good to review them because there are some techniques that you probably couldn't figure out by yourself. Thanks for looking at this short overview. Those videos are available, and hopefully you'll find them easy to use, and as soon as you take the videos, you'll be good to go, and you'll be sealing and signing all your documents in an automated workflow fashion, and you'll be a lot faster at what you've been doing. Thank you.